Welcome to Oracle CX Marketing Help Center videos. In this video, you'll learn about configuration iframes. As an app developer, you must develop API endpoints for your app so that when AMS calls your app's configured URL endpoint, your app responds with HTML content to fill the iframe within the CX product. This must be done in two scenarios throughout an app's lifecycle. 1. When an app is configured in the Oracle CX product, and 2. When the app service is configured. The CX app framework requires the use of PostMessage for communications in and out of iframes. PostMessage is the only allowed method, and so an understanding of PostMessage will be required. This video will walk through how to develop these endpoints for your app. We will walk through the configure URL and the save configuration URL for apps and services. Let's start with app configuration. When AMS calls an app's configure URL endpoint, apps have two options. Apps can display a default app configuration page, or in the scenario where the user previously configured the app can display the user's previous configuration page. Now for the save configuration URL. Apps must send the configurations to this endpoint to persist the user's configuration. For this, the app needs to send a post message to the parent iframe with the configuration slash payload they want to post to their endpoint. Let's take a look at the post message. The AMS action is save app config. The payload is the form data or object, that is whatever is configured by the marketer, and the request ID is save. The app can then send a message to the product to indicate the app configuration is saved, and the product can resume its process. Now we'll have a look at service configuration. These are the interactions where the service needs to interact with AMS. The first step is for the app to call AMS for the field metadata endpoint. The app must send this post message to the AMS iframe. This endpoint is provided by the CX product to AMS to send the app a list of fields the product provides for the account that are available for the app to use. Using responses as an example, the app is requesting all of the columns that responses provides in profile lists, profile extension tables, and so on, for that account. Next, the app asks AMS to fetch the fields from the product using the metadata URL from step 1. This is done by AMS, but the app sends a post message to the parent iframe. Note that the post message details where the AMS action is product and the destination URL is from step 1. Note that the app does not exactly communicate directly with the product here. The app just needs to send a trigger to the AMS iframe indicating the AMS action is product. Once the app has all the fields from AMS, step 3 is optional. You can then call the app's own endpoint to check if an older configuration exists for the service instance ID, similar to what we saw during app configuration. The app can then display a form or dropdown of all the fields the marketer can select to configure the service. The last step is to define how the configuration payload will be sent to the parent iframe. AMS will send the payload to the service's save configuration URL. The app can then send a message to the product to indicate the service configuration is done and the product can resume its process. Thank you for watching. For more information, see the links in the video description.